Hi there, awesome bakers. Welcome back to my channel, Glaze and Bakes. So today will be a very short video. I won't take up much of your time. I'll be showing you guys how to make some rolls, particularly the garlic roll and the school buns. Okay, so it's the same recipe for both. However, the difference is in the glaze that we'll be using. I didn't quite have not time actually, but I wasn't able to show you guys how to make the glaze, but they're very easy. So I'll just tell you guys how to do it because they're about like 2 minutes to make each, so I'll just describe and you'll be able to follow. So I hope you enjoy the recipe and I'd hope to try it out again. I'll see you at the end. So for this recipe, we'll be using 150 ml of milk as well as 150 ml of water, 4 cups of flour, 4 tablespoons of brown sugar, 100 grams of melted margarine, as well as 10 grams of instant yeast. So I'm going to start by adding my 4 cups of flour to my mixing bowl. In this recipe, we're going to be putting our dry ingredients together first, and then we'll add our wet ingredients later. Next up, I'm going to put 10 grams of instant yeast. And then after this, I'm going to add my 4 tablespoons of sugar. And then I'm going to mix my ingredients in the bowl. So now all my dry ingredients are done. So the median in the recipe is the margarine. So after mixing my flour, sugar, and yeast, I'm going to add my melted margarine. So it must be melted. You can melt this in the microwave or you can put it out in the sun, up to you. But your margarine must be melted. Then I'm going to mix the ingredients together until they're combined, avoiding lumps and bumps. Then I'm going to add my 150 ml of milk in with my water, and I'm going to mix that, and then I'm going to add my milk and water mixture into my flour, sugar, and yeast mixture. And then I'm going to knead and do some more kneading until it's combined and nice and stretchy. And then after this, I'm going to just coat the base of my bowl with your normal cooking oil, like your sunflower oil or olive oil or whatever it is that you use. It's okay, just so that the dough does not stick to the base of the bowl. And then I'm going to cover this in a plastic. You don't have to use plastic. I just prefer using plastic because of habit. But you don't have to use plastic. You can also use your fadook. Fadook being a dishcloth. But make sure that your dishcloth covers the whole bowl, right? And then you just put it out in the sun to bask. Or you can just put it in your warmer or your oven. But it must be in a warm place for about an hour until it has risen like that. So at this point, it must be smooth and it must be stretchy. There must be no bumps in your dough to show that it rolls properly, and it must have at least doubled in size. And then I'm going to section my dough into two, and then I'm going to section the two halves again into four, like that. And then once I'm done with this, I'm going to take the first quarter of my dough and I'm just going to section that into three equal little balls. Then I'm going to roll out my balls into this long rods, and I'm just going to braid this. So you're basically braiding this the same way you would braid your hair, just so that it looks good when it comes out of the oven. So this is how I do my braid, and then I just press it together at the end so that they don't loosen. So I'm going to repeat the same thing for another quarter of my dough. And then with the other two, because I'm doing both garlic bread and school buns, I'm going to leave them as the three little bolikis that we made. And I'm just going to put those six on the other side of my pan to make my school buns. So remember, your pan must be greased. You can either use butter or greasing spray or oil. I used cooking oil. Then I'm going to put my pan with my dough in a plastic again, and it's out in the sun to bask again for a further 30 minutes until they have doubled in size again or they fill the pan. So they should look something like this when you are done. Then I'm going to take my egg wash and I'm just going to put it over my dough. Don't use a lot of egg wash, just a little bit. You don't want your buns or your
bread to burn on top because it does have a tendency of doing that when you use a lot of egg wash. So I prepared another pan, right, just to show you guys what else you can do with your dough. So with this one, I just like sort of twisted them on top of each other instead of braiding, and this is what they look like. So for my garlic rolls, I just melted a little bit of butter or margarine, and I put garlic flakes in there and mixed it up, heated it in the microwave for 2 minutes. And then for my school buns, I used 2 tablespoons of sugar with a little bit of water, again in the microwave, and then just drizzled it on top. So this is how I served my garlic roll. I did a boerewors roll with some caramelized onions, and it was really yummy. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the recipe.